Hello, very warm good evening to all the students. We welcome you all on this doubt session of Codeable 2020 AI. Very good evening to all the students. Hello, Daksh. I, along with Pankaj sir, welcomes you on this Codeable 2020 AI doubt session. Very good evening, Jay, Manvi, Jenny, Arya, Devang. Okay, so students will be helping you with the doubts. Okay, we'll be starting in few minutes. Okay, yeah, very good evening to Malay, Vohra, Piyush, all the students and teachers and parents who are joining us on this webinar. We'll be starting in just few minutes. Okay, so that maximum number of students can join and can take this benefit of the webinar. Yeah, very good evening, Falak, Shubham, Tamanna, Manvi. Very good evening to all the students.
Good evening, everyone. It looks like a lot of you have some doubts. So we will be taking care of few of them in today's session, which are very which we have received that, okay, we are facing problems in this particular part. So we will be covering those parts. And later on, we will be having a series of doubt session on Zoom later on, like tomorrow and day after tomorrow as well, in order to solve your specific doubts. So like any specific doubts you have, then we will be solving it there. So there is one thing that you can do meanwhile. So if you have something like something which is like out of these demos and you want us to like solve those doubts, so please do one thing. We have a form on the on top of the chat. So please fill up the form so that we get your specific doubts. I'm just adding it again. So we will be going over the form and we will take out a few of the things, few of the topics today, and we will be taking out some more things later on, like tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So that we will be doing. So if you have any specific doubt which is out of these things, then please go over the form and submit the form. And while submitting the form, it's very important that you clearly mention what your problem is. If you just say, my code is not working, that won't help us identify the problem. So it's very important that you tell us what exactly you wanted to do and what is the problem, describe it, send us add a video of the problem as well. And also you can tell us, you can also send us your project file so that we can see if there is any particular error that you are getting. If we can solve it through the code, we would be doing that as well. But it's important that you all finish your projects. And for finishing your projects, it would be very much required that you get all your doubts solved as well. So we will try our best to solve all your doubts. But we are making the project for you. You will be doing it. We will be just guiding you. Okay, this is correct, this is wrong, and all those parts would be there. Yeah.
So I can see some students are asking if they don't have a doubt. So students, you can take the benefit if you want to learn, or if you don't have a doubt, then definitely you can work on your projects. Okay. So I'm sending out this feedback form link on the chat box. Okay, so you will be able to see this doubt form. So form link has already been pasted on the chat box. I'll paste it again so that it reaches to the maximum number of students. So as mentioned by Pankaj sir, so you can share your doubts and each and everything in the form, and so that we can reach out to you and help you in every circumstances. Definitely we won't be helping you with the projects that, but if there would be any difficulty you will be facing, definitely we'll help you in that case. Okay. Okay, great. So we'll just take
one more. I think we can start.
Okay.
I think people would be joining in, so we can start off with some of the doubts. There are some doubts in the chat that we can address before we go on there. Right. So someone has asked, what is the maximum size of the file? So it would be around 70 MB. So if your file is 70 MB, that would be good. So form link, you can find it on top of your chat. It's like it's already on top of the chat, and we are also circulating it. So people can also circulate it in the chat. I don't know my username and password, so we will be taking care about that as well. How can I log in? So that we will take care. Yeah, I think Ayush, what we can do is we can start off with this plan, and we can close down the chat as well, so that people can put their doubts in the doubt form, so that we are able to. And when you are putting the form, like when you are submitting the doubt form, please be descriptive. Not like my code is not working, I have a problem. Those things won't help us identify the problem. We will give us more information, and that using those information, we would be able to do it. So someone has asked, can we use extension in PictoBlocks like human detection? Yeah, you can do it. So everything which is available in PictoBlocks, you can use it. Yeah. Okay, Ayush. So I think you can start off.
Yeah, sure.
And then, yeah.
So first of all, again, I would like to welcome all the students, teachers, and everyone who has joined in this webinar. I, along with Pankaj, so welcomes you in this doubt session. And definitely we will try to solve everyone's doubt. Okay. So as sir said, we will take some of the doubts from the chat first. So someone has asked that already have been addressed, that we can use the extensions. So students, you can use any extensions which are in the PictoBlocks for making the projects. There is no problem with that. Okay. And let me take some more doubts. Yeah, you can update the projects. There's no problem. Okay, you can put the projects in the draft, and then afterwards you can put the correct project there. Okay. One question was very important to be answered. That was the last date of submission is 5th of January. Okay, it is already approaching. So we will request you to go towards the completion of your projects and start working on the submission part. So as now you can see on the screen that this is the plan what we are going to follow today, and we will try to take some more doubts along with this. So first thing, the doubt which we are going to handle is update the PictoBlocks. So right now, maximum, all of you might have received a notification in the PictoBlocks that you need an update, right? So some might have thought that we are stuck. Some might have thought what exactly has to be done. So first, I'm going to explain you how exactly you can come back and start using the PictoBlocks again after updating. So I'm sharing my screen, okay, and we'll see what is most important thing, because till the time you won't be able to use the PictoBlocks, it won't be easy for you to complete the projects, right? So I think my screen is very much visible to all of you, right? So right, the problem was I already updated my PictoBlocks. Okay. So, but I have some screenshots to share with you and to make you understand the things. So some of you might have seen this, the new version of PictoBlocks is available and you have to update. So you don't have to worry with anything, students. Just click on update. Okay. Although dialog box might look different in your case, don't worry with that. The only thing what you have to do is you have to click on update. When you are going to click on update, you will be directed to the Stempedia PictoBlocks download page. Okay. So you will be able to see that we have the latest update, that is Windows Installer 6 for 3.4.3. So all the things are updated here. Okay. So we will request you to complete this update process. You have to complete the update process if you are using Windows, if you are using Mac, Okay. So anything you are using, you have to complete the update process. After that, students, you will be clicking on the like installer, which you,
Yeah, I think your screen is not visible in the manner you are not showing the thing that you want, I guess.
Okay, I'll just share it again.
Yeah.
So is my this PictoBlocks update screen is visible?
No. You can share your whole screen, I guess. That would be more
appropriate. I'll just share the screen. Just a moment. I'll just check it once. Is it visible now?
No, the webinar jam thing is visible.
Okay. Need to check. Just a moment, I'll just check it. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll just go and directly open the download link so that I can like help them with the process.
Yeah, definitely.
Is the screen visible now or is it not visible till now?
Yeah.
Is it visible?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay, so PictoBlocks update, right?
Yes.
Wonderful. So now, students, I was talking about this thing only that you might be seeing this dialog box or some similar dialog box in your PictoBlocks. So you have to click on update here, okay? Once you will be like clicking on update, you will be directed to the, as I told, the PictoBlocks download page. So is Pankaj sir, is this visible? The download page of PictoBlocks? Okay, wonderful.
Yes.
Okay, so students, now you can see that we have come up with a new updates and with new features, okay? So definitely we want you all to update with these features, whether you are using Windows or you are using Mac OS. So there is an update version for both the things. So you have to like update first download. So once you will be clicking here, you will be finding a dialog box where you have to give your like name and email ID. And once you will be submitting it, you will find that PictoBlocks has started download. So I have seen like some student told that we clicked on the download, but it's not showing anywhere where exactly I have led. So you don't have to worry. You will be able to see that at the bottom, you can see the PictoBlocks setup, right? So it will take a little bit of time because it's a little like a big file, not big file, but yeah, it's like 424 MB file, right? So it will take 1 to 2 or 5 minutes to download. Once this PictoBlocks file will be downloaded, you will be able to see this on your downloads. Okay. So you can see this is a PictoBlocks file, exe file, which you have to like install. So this is setup file. When you will be double clicking on this file, student, you will be seeing something like this, which is saying, do you want to allow this app to make changes your device? So you have to click yes here. So I think many of you might have done this before as well, right? So this is a similar process when the first time you might have downloaded and installed the PictoBlock. The similar things we are doing again. So you have to click yes here. And once you will be clicking here, yes, you will find this completing PictoBlock setup. And once you'll be clicking here, finish, it will start, it will like open the PictoBlocks in your PC. Okay. And the problem which many of you might be facing, like you are seeing you were not able to use the PictoBlocks, this will be solved. And also you will experience some more good features as well as you will find the PictoBlocks much more convincing, okay? So I think this part is very clear to everyone. So I think we should take a short poll, sir, on this.
Yeah, I guess there is a one more thing. So this update was actually meant for the Windows, Mac, and Linux. So people who are using the Android app won't, like, they don't require any update. So they, if they require any update, then they're and like they can check in their Play Store and like they can identify whether the, an update is required or not. So it's a very like it was a compulsory update for all of you who are using it in Windows, so that you will get updated with the latest Picto block. So after that, once you like reinstall the program, it will be working very fine. So this was one problem that that was coming. So I think we can take a poll. So how many of you have is this problem clear to all of you? So we are just taking a poll. So this was because of like download issue that was happening. Okay. So we are just talking about, are you facing any problem with downloading PictoBlocks or installing the new version? So that would be the major question. I think some people neglected that part. So I am just resetting the poll and starting it again. So are you finding problem in downloading? So just answer yes or no. So based on that, we will be covering more problems again. So currently, if you are facing any problem with PictoBlocks download, or your PictoBlocks is like outdated and it asks you to ask you again and again that you have to update, if you are facing those problems, then this is the solution that you will be getting. Okay. I guess we have a lot of people cleared on the doubt, so I think we can move on. People who are still facing doubt, they can, like, we will be making this video public in YouTube, so it will be there for the reference as well, so they can take care, they can go over the video again. We can move to the next part, which is how to log in PictoBlocks. So maybe Ayush, you can show how to log in PictoBlocks in laptop, and then I will show it in the mobile application. A lot of you had this problem, so we will be taking care of this. So yeah.
Okay. So like I saw the polls, and yeah, so maximum of you have like understood, but I'll just give you a short recap again. Okay. But I'll not show the things, but I'll tell you. So try to focus, students. You don't have to worry anything. You have to just click on update. Okay. It will automatically direct you to the website. Just download the installer. Go to your download folder in your PC. Double click the setup and just click next, and you will be finished. Everything is done. Okay. Just three steps thing is this. Okay. Still, but if you are finding any problem, you can like always refer to the video, as Pankaj sir has told you that we will be putting this video in the YouTube. So now let's get into the second problem, that is login. So many, like, I think maximum of.
One more thing, if you are still facing problem in updating PictoBlocks, then please fill up the doubt form. We will take care, like, we will come back to you if you are facing this particular doubt. And if you're facing any particular doubt that we are not covering it here, so I'm just sharing it. So if you are facing any particular doubt, if you're like, we are not covering here, so you can also put that thing into the feedback, like doubt form. Go on, Ayush, on the login part here.
So now I'll tell you, students, there are two things. Okay, I just received a message as well that I have forgot the username. Okay, so students, you can always ask the things on the chat box. Okay, you don't have to worry. So now I'll take care of these two things, and I'll tell you that if you are using laptop or PC, how you can do that. And after that, the Pankaj sir will help you how you can do that in Androids. Okay, so let's start with the laptop and PC. So I'm sharing my screen. Okay. So, sir, is my PictoBlocks screen visible?
Yeah, it's visible. Yeah.
Okay, great. So, students, you can see right now I'm already logged in. Okay. So, what I'm going to do is I'm showing you the whole process. Okay. So right now I'm signing it out. Okay. Just give me a moment. Now just see the process very carefully. Okay. It's very easy. So you have to click on sign in. Once you'll be clicking on sign in, you have to click join. Okay. Once you'll click on join, there are two options. Okay. So let me clear one thing to all of you, that even if you are not like 16 year old, okay, you can use PictoBlocks. There is not a problem in that. Okay. So if I'm choosing no, I'm getting an option to give my guardian's email ID. Although if I'm choosing it, like I'm 16 year old, yes. So I'll have to give my email ID. That's only different. Okay. The thing as like you might have already knew that we have already explained you in webinars that we have to give here the email ID. So what I'm going to do here is I'll give a email ID here. Okay. Okay, so see, you can see this email ID I have given here. Okay, so it's okay. So what I'm going to do is I have to click on submit here. Okay, just see this. Once I clicked here on submit student, you can see it is written waiting for approval. We have sent on this email ID, right? So it means that an email has been sent by PictoBlocks in your email ID. Now, what you have to do here is, students, you have to go to that email ID and check the email, right? So how you can do that? So it's very simple. First, like I'll just show you, but I'll go to that email ID. Okay, so now you can see, just a moment. Yeah, so now you can see the email just arrived by the first one, right? You can see it's nearly there. Please activate your PictoBlocks account. So you will be receiving it. You can see just in 0 minute it has received, right? So now, students, the next step is you just have to click here on activate account. Okay. Once you'll be clicking here on activate account, you have to just wait for like few seconds so that you can see a notification over here. You will be able to see that just in like a minute.
And also, if you are not able to find this email, then like search it in your spam. So like sometime in some people email, it goes into spam. So search it in the spam and you would be able to find it. So yeah.
So like now you can see it has been mentioned that email has been successfully verified. Okay. So now the email is verified, right? Now you have to create your username. So you don't have to do anything. Just go back to PictoBlocks directly. Okay. I'm just going back to PictoBlocks and now you will be able to see the screen here, which is asking me to create a username. So what I'm going to do is I'll create a username. Just see it. Okay. So Ayush underscore, I'll just write one more Ayush. I'll write. Okay. The most important thing is like, you don't have to use a space in between. Okay. So don't use space or any other special characters. If you want, you can use this underscore, or else you can keep it very short, just of 6 letters. I'll just keep the password. Okay.
So yeah, a lot of you also won't know what the password is. So password is something which you and only you should know in order to get access to your account. So it's a method, like it's a very standard method in which you can protect your account and you can protect something. So like if you want to protect your house, how do you protect? With a locker, and then you have a key. So this password is like a key which you and only you would have. And with the key, you would be able to access or log in into the account. So it's very important that you have it in unique, have a very unique password. And it should not be that difficult that you forget it very easily. So make sure you keep it something which is very easy to remember, and you won't be able to something which you can remember very easily. Yeah.
So students, I think this part is very clear to you, that what is exactly is password, right? So you have to keep a password. Okay. You have to create you are creating here a new password to protect your account. So now you have to select your date of birth. So I'll just select it. Okay. So
And if you are 16 year or less, then you have to select your age. Date of birth would not be there.
One very important, like we have seen one very problem which some students are facing, that in the first step you are selecting that you are 16 year old, yes. And after that, when you are putting your date of birth, you are like putting that you are not 16 year old, right? So if you are mismatching that thing, then you might be in like little problem and you will not be able to create the account. So as I mentioned, if you are not 16, mention, no there, put your guardian's email ID, activate your account and choose your age. Okay. After that, students, you have to select the gender. Okay. So gender and select the country. And once you will be filling all these details, you have to click on submit. Okay. You will be able to see that once I click on submit, your account has been created successfully. And also I am logged in here, right? So I think this is very clear to everyone. Now, students, I will tell you the second part of this. Like we have seen, we just saw some students asked that if in case you might have created some username and you have forgotten, right? So how you can retrieve that? So right now I'm signing out myself and just see a very important thing, students. I've seen many students like who are putting their email ID here. Students, you don't have to put your email ID here. Okay. So you just now saw that I created a username, which was Ayush_Ayush. Okay. So that I should say that username you have to put and the newly created password you have to give. The second part comes like if you have like forgotten what exactly was your username. Okay. Or the password. So here on this page, you have to click on forgot password. Okay. Now, if you are like, if you know the username and if you have just forgotten the password, so you can put your username here and send a password reset link. Although if you don't remember the username as well, so what has to be done here is just give your, I should say your email ID. So I just created an account, right? So I'll just put that email ID. Okay. So now you can see, just think in a case I have like forgotten my username and password both, but I know that which email ID I might have used here. So I have kept this email ID here. I'll send a reset password link. Okay. So now you can see reset password link has been sent. So we'll go back to my email ID and we'll see whether we have received something or not. So now you can see once again, I have received one email. So here now students, see it very carefully that if you remember your username, okay, then in that case, directly click on reset password and reset it. If in case you have forgotten your username as well, so you can see, hey, Ayush_Ayush. So this is your username, right? So now what you can do is you can reset your password. You will be able to track that what is your username, and using all these things, you will be again be able to, I should say, log in. So what I'll do is I'll just show you that first. So I'll click on reset password. Okay, so you have to just put your new password. So I'll just put a new password. So now you will be able to see, whoa, the password reset successfully. Now you can continue your coding journey. So again, I'll go back to my sign in. Okay, now I know my username as well. So it was Ayush_Ayush. Okay, and the password what I just created was this. So I'll click here, sign in, and I will be signed in. So I think you might have understood the things very clearly. Okay, so yeah, I'll stop my screen here.
Yeah, so now I think we can go on with the mobile version part of it. The process would look very much similar, but there would be few changes to it as well. So So I will just start the broadcasting, and I will just share the screen with you. So a lot of you are working on your mobile phones as well, and we understand that when we are working on mobile phone, there are some restrictions. So in PictoBlocks, if you work on desktop, it would be very it would be a little bit easier. But when you are working on the mobile phone, it becomes a little bit harder, as you have to do a lot of work. Like a lot of things are being done on the small small space. So what I will do, I will just go and open PictoBlocks. So I have my PictoBlocks open. So now, as I have my PictoBlocks open, the first thing that you would be seeing is we have this dashboard, or the main area or the main homepage of PictoBlocks. So as you can see here, we have MySpace, examples, projects, shop, and all those things we have. So what I will do is, as you can see, I am already logged in. I will just click on here, and okay, I'm not logged in, but yeah, you would be able to see that there is a sign of this person. Okay, so this icon is actually showing your account. So same way you had in the desktop app, you have the same account in PictoBlocks app as well. So if you want to work on both desktop and in PictoBlocks app, then you don't have to create username or two accounts. You can use one account only. So what I will do is I will show you how you can sign in into PictoBlocks, or how you can create your account as well. So the first thing that we have to do is if you are inside PictoBlocks, you won't be able to create your account. So you have to come back to the home screen, and then you would be able to create your account. So what we will be doing is we will be going and clicking on this button. So this button we will click, which is shows us the sign of account. So I will just click on this button. And as you are able to see, a similar thing is happening here. So it says sign in, and then there is a register button. So if you are creating a new account, then you have to click on register, and the same process would go on. So are you older than 16 or not? Okay, so I am saying no, I'm not. Okay, suppose I am a kid who is of 7 year age. So I would be selecting no. And so when I click on this no, then it will be asking me about my guardian's consent. And this is very much important. So what you have to do is you have to write your guardian email. Okay, so maybe I will add my email ID there, and I agree, and I will just click on send. You are able to see? Yeah, so I clicked on agree, and I sent. Okay, so as you can see here, it says we have sent an email to pverma@dustandmedia.com. So and we are waiting for approval. So what I will do is I will just click go back. I will open my Gmail, and in my Gmail I would be receiving an update from Stempedia. So here is the update. So my update is here, and as you can see here in this update, it's written parents consent for PictoBlocks account registration. So this email would be going to your parents' email ID, which you would have said. You just have to click on I agree, or your parent has to click on I agree so that they give their consent, and you would be getting the same thing here as well. So now what you have to do is you have to go back to PictoBlocks. So I can go back to PictoBlocks, and I can click on PictoBlocks. And now, as you would see, what you have got is you have got the same thing, but you have to put more information into it, or you have to complete your account. So I would put a username, maybe Pankaj 121. I have put Pankaj 121 as the username, and maybe if I want to have some password, I would just put it. Suppose for this, I am putting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Keep it something which is not obvious and which you can remember. I already told you what the password is. And as you can see here, it's asking for the age. So if you are below 16 year, it would ask for your age, and I am 7 year old. So I have put 7, and it by default, it has selected India, and I will just submit it. So with this, what we would be having is we would have my account created successfully. If you want to put your so these are the things you would be able to see. Okay, so yeah, so these things we have here. So now what I will do, I will just sign out, and I will just show you how you can sign in. Okay, so why does a signing is required? A signing is required when you are using AI-based extensions. Then in that you would have to sign in. So what you have to do is you have to click on this button, and then you just have to put your whatever you have put for the account, and then the password, and then you would be able to sign in. Okay, so I think I have put my password as wrong. So suppose, yeah, I forgot my password. Okay, so now what I have to do? So I have to click on forgot password, and it would be a similar process. So I know my username, so I can like click on the username part, and then I can send, and it would show me, please check your mail. So what I can do is I can just go back to my mails, and I would be able to get, see a mail coming on from PictoBlocks that your account password has been, like we have received a reset request. I would click on reset password. And when I click on reset password, it would again ask me for a new password. I can click on it I can just submit a new password, maybe a simple one. So reset password. And then the next thing would be to go back to PictoBlocks and just log in. So it's very important that you like log in if you are using your extensions, which is basically artificial based, like AI extensions, then you have to log in. So if you are logged in, then you would be able to successfully do some things. And so these are the things that we have to cover with the login part. So yeah, so this part is clear. So we would ask how many of you are clear on the login part? Login, sign in, all this creation based parts. How many of you are clear, or you have some doubts, then you can say no. Yeah. I think most of you are clear. So people who are still facing the problem, what they have to do now is they have to submit their doubts onto the form that we are circulating, and post the picture of the particular thing that you are facing. So suppose in sign-in or in registration, if there is any part which is showing any error, then post the photo of that part. And it's very important that you post the photo, otherwise we won't be able to clearly know where the problem is. So if you are still facing problem in sign-in, then we will be making this video go on YouTube, and then you can go over there and see. And otherwise, you just submit a feedback on this feedback form. We are receiving a quite a few of the problems that people are facing. We will be taking care of those problems tomorrow and day after tomorrow as well. So yeah, Ayush, you can go further with this third part.
So I think maximum of you have understood this, how exactly you have to sign into your laptop or PC, or how you have to sign into the PictoBlocks application, right? So now the next thing is that you have downloaded, you have updated your PictoBlocks. You are now signed in as well. So now you might be working with your projects, right? And after working with this project, you have to submit this project to the Codeever. Okay, so now I will show you. It's like we have already talked about, but I will tell you in disc, like in a full manner, that how exactly you have to submit the projects. What are the different parts which you have to take care of, right? So now I'll show you. Just give me a moment. I'll share my screen. So for submitting a project on the Codeever, students, okay, so this is like many of you already know, but if some of you are finding a problem, let me show you from very basic. That first we'll go to the register, the Codeever website. Okay, so I'm sharing my screen now.
And also one thing is the Codeever website user ID and login or team detail and the login part would be different from what you have in PictoBlocks app. Okay, so both the ID would be different.
So yeah, so as mentioned by Pankaj sir, right? So I think you might have understood that the username and the password what you have created in the PictoBlocks is totally different thing, and the team registration did for the Codeever was totally different thing. Okay, so I think if you are like, you have already like visited this website many number of times, right? So now see the process. Although we will be sharing you the links and everything, you don't have to worry. Okay, but see this part. When you are coming on this website, and now is the high time, you already know only 3 to 4 days are left here, so you will be submitting your project. So what you have to do is you have to click on login, right? So I think this login button is visible to everyone. You have to click on login here, students. Once you'll be clicking it on login, it will be asking your team name and the password. So one, like not all students, but I have like came across some doubts. So students, just read it carefully that it is written team name or email ID, right? So whether you can give your team name or the email ID, you don't have to give both the things. Okay, so now you can see my team name is Ayush_demo and my password is like what exactly I kept while registration, right? So I will be using these two credentials, and after this I will be clicking on login button. Once I will be logging in my dashboard, I'll show you the submission page. So many of you visited or might have visited on this page, right? So you had the learning tutorials, right? So you might have gone through with the learning tutorials. After all the things like making project and everything, you have to click on the submit project, okay? So I'm clicking on submit project. And now we'll see all the things very carefully, each and every part, okay? So now you can see this is a submission page, students. Okay, so it is I would suggest you not to rush for the last hour for submissions, because it needs your patience. It needs your, it is very important basically, because everything mentioned here is containing marks, right? So you have to give a little bit of time and then submit. Okay, so don't wait for the last time. Start submitting your project once you are completed with it. So now the first thing is project name. So here, students, whatever project you have made, okay, you might have given certain name to it, so you have to put that name. So I'll just select I'll just select mask detector. Okay, now the second part comes.
Yeah. If you can zoom your thing, then it would be great.
Okay, great.
Yeah, if you can zoom on it. Yeah, maybe a little bit more.
Yeah, I think it's good.
Now it's
so good. Now, students, just see this part that you have to give your project name. So whatever project you have made, you might have given certain name to it, right? So you have to keep that name here. This is very mandatory. You can see already the star mark is there. Now the things come up with the themes. Okay. So in the starting, and already you know that your project is related to one theme. So you have to select that theme in which your project is related to. Like, I have made a mass detector, so I can choose like beat the pandemics with artificial intelligence, right? Now the third part comes here of the project category. So now, students, you have to understand very carefully that here it is a multiple tick option, right? So you don't have to tick everything. You have to only tick those ideas here, those categories here, on which you have worked upon your project. Like, for making mass detector, I have used artificial intelligence and machine learning. So I'm clicking on artificial intelligence and machine learning. I have not made any game here. I have not used any hardware here. I have not used any storytelling part. Okay, so I'm just clicking it here on the AI ML project. If in case you might have made a game where you have used artificial intelligence, in that scenario, you will be clicking on the first and the second, right? So this is the way you have to like select the category for as of now. As I told, my project only contained the artificial intelligence and machine learning part. So I'm clicking it here with an artificial intelligence and machine learning project. Now, students, this part is something where you have to be very creative. Okay, so you have given so much time for making the project. So now it's time to like give a short description and explanation of the project, that how exactly you worked upon, what were the things which came across like making the project, okay, and how exactly your project is working. So for as of now, like, I'll just choose a random text here, okay? So I'm just choosing a random text. So I've put certain text here, that is, this is my project description, but you have to be very careful while writing your own project description, because as you know that all these things, all these parts contain certain marks, right? After this, students, you have to like explain your project. Okay, so again, I'm like putting the same text here, but as I mentioned, you have to be very descriptive. You can like attach the photos here, okay? And you have to like explain the things in detail, that how exactly your project works. Yeah.
Can you add how to add a photo? You can show it.
I think attach a link, right? So either.
Click on insert.
Okay.
On top of this, okay, right, insert. Right.
Yeah. So from here, student, you can see it's an insert part. Here you have to like, you can insert any image. So I'll just select an image. Okay. Now I think this is an advanced. So you have to like, I think you have to give the source here, right?
Oh, it's not upload. Okay.
So what I can, I think like Pankaj sir, you can like show this part of like insertion of image, right? I think.
You can move ahead and I will tell you.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you can move ahead. I will just tell into some time.
Right. So now, students, you can see that I have kept my explanation, and we will be telling you that how exactly you are going to insert the image. After that, student, you have to upload your project file. Okay, so now see this, that you are only allowed to submit one file only here. Okay. Second thing is the maximum size allowed is 70 MB. Okay, so I'm going to just select a file here. Okay, so I'll go to my like the file where exactly I have saved it. So just give me a moment. Right, so now I'll choose my file, that is of mask detection. So I've just selected this. Okay, so now you can see it is of 57 KB, and it will take a little bit of time, like it will show you uploading part. After this, student, the next part is, now you can see the project has already been uploaded here. The next part is that you have to submit a video here, so video link basically of YouTube. Before that, we will help you to how to make a video, and then we will come back to this point, that how you can upload a video, and to the YouTube, and how you can paste the link here. Right. So right now I'm stopping my share. I think this is very clear to the students. I'll just give you a short recap. You have to give the project name. You have to select your project theme. You have to select the category on which your project means the on the ideas, what you have used in your projects. You have to give a project short description, explanation, and you have to like upload your project file. So one, I saw one doubt were coming, like somewhere asking like, sir, do I have to upload my project video or project like video link? So student, both the things are mandatory. So you have to upload your project file as well as you have to give the project video link. So both are mandatory and both you have to give here. So I'll just stop the share. Okay. And yes, sir.
Yeah. So you can keep on sharing it. So I think mobile phone, the thing would be looking very similar. So I will just show them how to log in, and maybe they can do the part very easily as well. So I will just start again. Yeah. So in the mobile phone, when you are doing it, I am just sharing it. You can stop sharing the screen. I will just share it. So when you are doing it in your mobile phone, then the first thing that you have to do is you have to go to Codeever. So once you go to Codeever, so as you can see here, you would be able to see this part. I'll just close this. Okay, now one thing that you have to make sure is if you are already registered on it, then what you have to do is there is a menu button there on top right. Just click on the menu and you would be able to see the different options. And if you have registered already, you don't have to register again. You just have to click on login. Register is a one-time process, and login is the thing that you would be doing again and again in order to access your account. So I will just click on login. I will just add the details. So I guess I will just add it like this. I will just click, I will just add my details. Just a second. So once you click on it, login and click on login, you would be able to log in. And once you log in, you would be able to see something like this. You would be able to go to your dashboard. So I would just go to Codeever dashboard. So like I will just click on here and go to dashboard, and in the dashboard you would be able to see that there are some cards. Okay, so like you can download PictoBlocks, you can learn about the things, and you can submit a project. All those things you would be able to do. So what I will do, I will just click on submit project. It will pop this button. I will click on the submit project, and you would be able to go to the submit project, and you would be able to like find the details that you have to submit. So like you have to write a project name. Now in the project theme, you have to select only one theme. You cannot make project in more than one theme. So that's why it's a drop down menu. So your theme would be one, but your project category can be like many. So it can be like you are making in two category, three category, but it's not like if you are making only one category, you would be getting less marks. It's not of that part, but we wanted to like see what are the different categories you are working on. So this is the category part. Then you would be doing short description. You would be explaining your project, selecting your files, and all those things you would be doing. So one major thing that people face in mobile phone is how they can submit the project in their this thing. So what I will do is I will just go to PictoBlocks again. And suppose I have my this project, mouse. Okay, so if I want to submit this project in my in there, what do I have to do? Okay, so first thing that you have to understand is when you are working in the mobile phone, you have to keep saving your projects, because when you switch your phone like this, then there would be some kind of disconnect that you would be getting. So like your project would be cached, or project there would be some time that you forget that you have to again come to PictoBlocks and your project would be lost. So what you have to do is you have to go back into PictoBlocks. Then whatever file that you want to share, just click on it. Then there would be a tick mark. Okay. So when this tick mark comes, it means that the file is being selected. And now what I can do is I can click on this share button. So there is a share button here, and I can click on this share button, and you can find a method in which you can get the files inside your mobile phone. Okay, so it can be something like I am getting it on my WhatsApp, or it's the other things as well. So what I will do, I will just get it into my WhatsApp. So I will just send it to someone, maybe Ayush only. And once I send it to Ayush, I have the file Ayush. And as you can see, I can just download it as well. So like this, I would be able to do it. Okay. So this is how you would be able to get the PictoBlocks file there. So I will just go back and just download the PictoBlocks file from there. So in WhatsApp, it's very easy. You can just download it, or like it's shared in your those things, like in your WhatsApp media. And once you have done that, you can just add the file into your project. So like when you select this, you would be able to go to files, maybe on WhatsApp, it would be there. I have to search it where my WhatsApp files are being stored, or maybe I can go here and maybe most recent one. So I have to see where my WhatsApp I will just check it. Ayush, you can take it forward. I will just check it and show them.
So students, so the thing is, now you might as we have already told you that the time is approaching. So that's why we are focusing more on the submission, because definitely we want you to submit the file. Okay. And wait for the results as well. So we showed you how exactly you can submit it through the laptop or PC. And if in case you don't have laptop or PC, we are telling you that how you can share it, how you can upload your file to the submission page of Codeever using a mobile. So what exactly Pankaj sir has did, I'll just give you a short recap of that. Okay, so what he did, he went into the PictoBlocks application, and there was an option of MySpace there. He went there and shared that file to someone. So that was me, definitely. So you can share it to your parent or someone's, right? And after that, you have to download it. Once you will be downloading it, you will be getting it in your device. So what you have understood, the file was not in your device previously. Okay, so you have to share it to someone, and then you will download it. Then you will be able to find it in your the device, the mobile. Okay, so I think Pankaj sir, have you received the file?
Yeah, I'm just seeing the WhatsApp thing where it's download the files. So I will just check it, and maybe you can move forward with the part where you are showing how to how to record video is the
part. So students, I'll just give you a brief for some time. Okay, so there are two things here. that you will be making a video, okay, of your file, and you will be uploading it to the YouTube, right? And then you have to paste that YouTube link to the submission page, right? So now the things come up that many of you have asked the question that what exactly we have to make in video. So students, how you can start with the video is with the self-introduction, that you can give your name, you can tell your school name, okay, where exactly you have located. After this, you can start with the project name. So I have made mass detector. Okay. After that, you can show the codes that what exactly you have done it on there. You can explain the part, right? So what I'll do is I'll just share my screen. Okay. And I'll try to explain you little parts of mass detector. So it will be like helping you as well. Like it will give you a short recap of that project as well, right?
Yeah.
So I'll just share my screen.
Maybe I can just let them see the part on how to do it. Maybe a simplified version of it, and then you can take it forward. Yeah. So what you can do is you can get it emailed to yourself as well, and that would be very easy for you to download. So you can just click on download, and it would be downloaded like this. So now when my download is complete, I can just go and I can just go to the part where I'm like submitting the project, which was this. I can go, I can see the downloads, and here I would be having the first, I can just see my mouse project is there. I can just click on it, and my file would be uploaded. So when your file is uploaded, then you would be able to see something like this, and you would have the uploaded file. Okay. So this part is, I think, would be clear. So how you can do it, you can mail it to yourself. So in PictoBlocks, there is an option to like mail the file to yourself as well. So you can just click, you can just share, and yeah. So you can just go here, you can click here, you can just share, and so click share, and then you can Gmail it to you as well. So that would be a very easy method to do it, because WhatsApp media is shared, like is saved, and it's like very hard to find where the WhatsApp is. A lot of you might be expert in that, I'm not. So that's why I was finding it difficult. But you can definitely email it to yourself, and then you would be able to do it. Yeah, Ayush, you can move.
Yeah, so further. I was like telling them a little description that what they have to cover in their video. Okay, so I'll just share my screen and tell them. Okay, so I'm just sharing my screen, students. So I think this is very visible to everyone, right? The PictoBlocks. So I'll just open that project file first. Okay, so just give me a moment.
And also, till the time Ayush is opening, people who are facing problems, they can put their problems in the doubt form. This is a generic thing that we are covering. And if you have any specific doubts, then please put out the doubts in the doubt form.
Yeah, so like students, now you can see I have like opened this PictoBlocks, I have opened this mass detection file. So now we will be telling you how you will be using, like how you will be recording the video, okay? But what are the different things which you have to cover in the video, I'm telling you right now. Okay, so now, as I mentioned, once you will be start recording your like screen recorder, okay, whether you are using an Android phone or you are using a laptop, you will be start, you will be starting your screen recorder. After that, first you will be covering your self-introduction. After that, what you can do is you can explain. You have to basically, if you are like, as I told you, every part in the code ever is going to give you certain marks. The more you will explain in a good way, the more marks you are going to get. Okay. So now, as I told, so my name is Ayush. I'm currently working as an AI instructor in STEMpedia, and I have made a project of mass detection. Now I would like to explain you the project. So now, student, you can start explaining the part. Okay, what you can do is, like, you can first start with what are the different components you have used. So right now you can see I have used an extension of machine learning. So you can tell I have used an extension of machine learning so that I can make my machine learn and get the output whether the person is wearing mask or not. Now you can explain a big parts, like I have turned on the video, then I have used a forever block so that my projects can work again and again. And then similarly, you can explain your whole project. So you don't have to go very like precise, like I have used a green flag to activate this account. So more, okay, but you have to explain maximum of the things. Okay, that is definitely going to give you the marks. After that, what you can do is,
and also,
yeah,
and also one part you can cover, if you are doing machine learning, then you can cover how you have trained the model. So you can show the multi-cable machine thing as well.
Right. So yeah, as like this was very important. So if you have like used the machine learning extension, definitely you have used a teachable machine part, right? So now you are like having one more thing to explain. So it will be like much more beneficial for you. And there you can explain that how exactly the model is working, what are the labels, like what are the classes, right? After that explanation of all these things, you have to show your demo. Okay, you can go to full screen and show the demo how exactly the project is working. After this, student, there is a short part, and definitely we want you to cover that part, that how exactly you have come up to this project. So what you can say here is that, like, if I am like covering the last part of this mass detection, I have been seeing the pandemics, which is going from so long, and it has hit the like world with a very big hammer, right? So definitely my project is going to help the humanity and will be helping and will be like focusing on the people to make them wear masks and detect if they are not wearing. And if they are not wearing, we can ask them to wear the mask again, right? So I'm not right now, definitely not prepared with that, but you have to come up with the preparation. You can write the things up. Then you can come up and explain the things and record everything. How the recording will be done, that now the Pankaj sir will tell you. Yeah, so I think, yeah, Pankaj sir.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, definitely. So what I will do, I will just open PictoBlocks, and I have my PictoBlock open. So what you can do is, yeah, I will just share the screen. I'm just opening a project, a random project, maybe, yeah, I will just open a random project, maybe face recognition. Yeah. So what we will be doing right now is, once you have the project ready, so as Ayush have already told you, you have to do some certain things in order to, like, there are a few things that you have to cover. What is the motivation that you have behind the project? What motivates you to, like, do the project or the problem? And then you have to explain how you approached it. In that, you can cover the teachable machine part, you can cover your code and all those stuff. And then once that is done, then maybe you can, like, maybe what we can do is, after that you can do certain things like showing the output of the project, how the project is performing. And then if you are having a hardware project, then you can take the video of the hardware or the project that is running, and then you can put it out like that. So this would be the part which would be very much appreciated, because a very big portion of the codeover part is on submitting, like marks is on submitting project, and your presentation would be very much important. So as you can see here, what I have is I have my PictoBlocks project open. And as you can see, currently in this form, I have my video coming onto the stage, with video from another camera is coming directly on the stage. So what you can do is, the next thing that I will be telling you is, when you are like working on the Windows, or like when you are working on like Windows, Mac, or any PC, then there is a software which you can use in order to record the video. So that software is, we call it OBS. So this is, it's a very popular software. All your like whatever, like streamers use this software in order to stream on YouTube. So you can, but it's very easy to use as well. So what you can do is you can just, I have put the link into the group chat. You can download the screen recorder on your like laptop as well. And what you will get is you will get something like this. So I will just get it here. Just a second, I will. So what you will get is you will get something like this. So when you open OBS, you will get something like this. And as you can see here, I have some things running on. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to first go to here. And this is only for people who are working on the laptops. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to set up the scene. Okay. So for that, you have to click on this add button on the top left corner. You will be getting the recording of this whole video, so you can go over and see how you can make the videos as well. So click on this, and maybe I can write whatever. So this is something I have this thing here. Now the next thing that I have to add is this is the screen that we will be recording. Okay, so what we want here is we want here to see what PictoBlocks is showing. Okay, and let's see how we can add that. So in this the second box we have the sources, so we will be adding the sources into it now. So what I will do, there is an add button, and I will click on this add button, and I will add a display capture, or maybe not display capture, a window capture. Okay, so this window capture, what it will do is it will just I will just click on window capture. I will just say PictoBlocks and click on OK. And then it will ask me which window to capture. Okay. So what I can do is I can see there in the Windows option, there are a lot of things going on. I can just select PictoBlocks. And now I have PictoBlocks on my screen coming on. Okay. I can just click on PictoBlocks and I can click on OK. And now I have PictoBlocks running on the screen. And as you can see here, PictoBlocks is running on. Okay. So like this, you would be able to add PictoBlocks into the sources. Like you would be able to add the source as PictoBlocks, and you would be able to see whatever is happening. So now if I just go to PictoBlocks and do something like click here or those things, you would be able to see that, okay, this is real time. Things are happening in real time. Now the next thing is you are also adding your voice into the video. You are explaining the project. You are doing those stuff. What you have to do is you have to add the voices as well. So what I will do, I will just click on the source again, and I will add audio input capture. So audio input capture is a part where you would be capturing my audio from mic. So I will just click on audio input capture. I will click on OK, and it will just give me the sources. I can set it as default as well, or you can choose a specific device as well. So if you have your headphones or like mics, then you can use it as well. And when I add it, you would be able to see that there is a bar running on here. So whenever I'm talking, it's going towards right. Now you can see it's going towards right. Okay, so this is the input bar from your mic that is coming on. There is one more thing that you can do. You can click on add, and you can add audio output capture as well, which would record whatever voice that is coming out of your speaker. So that would add those part, and it would, and here you can choose the speaker that you want to add. Okay, so it's all this basic process that we have. So like this, you would be able to like set up the screen. And as you can see, we have the audio level coming on from the mic and from the like desktop as well. Now, the next thing that we have to do is there is a button called start recording. So maybe Ayush, you can put us on here, maybe here. So in the right side, we have some buttons. So the second button is start recording. And when I click on this start recording, the recording would start. And now what I can do is I can go into Pictoblocks and I can say whatever I want. So I can just do, okay, yeah, I want to have this to be, like you can explain your project, you can explain how this thing is working. You can just click on this part and you can see if it's identifying me or not. And as you can see, it's identifying me. So this is how you would be able to record the video. And then what you have to do is you just have to stop recording. And when you click on this stop recording, your recordings would be stored in your device. How you can get it? You can get it from File and Show Recordings. And it will show all the recordings that you have done. So like I will just go to here. So it shows the recording that I have done. There are a lot of previous recording that I had. So one of them would be that this one is the latest one, and this one is the one we have captured. So this is the method in which you would be able to capture whole of your Pictoblocks, and you would be able to explain your project better. So like this, you would be able to record the video very clearly, and you would be able to make the things work very easily as well. So what you have to do, you have to set up a new scene. Then you have to add sources. So in the source, you will be adding three sources. One source would be Pictoblocks. The other source would be the audio input, which would be mic. And the third source would be audio output, which would be speaker. And this is how you, and once that is done, just click on start recording, stop recording, and then you can do all the things. And in YouTube, you would be able to find a lot of other things as well, how to edit it, how to do it. So like when I'm starting recording, you can also pause the recording if you want to break. Okay, so that is also something which you can do. And we have received a lot of videos which are very, very good in terms of the project explanation and these parts. So this is the thing I think you should be focusing on. The next part, if you're not able to do this, the next thing that you can do, the next easiest thing that you can do is just have your camera from your mobile phone, show the camera on top of your screen, and just add the video or show the different code, show how it's working from the mobile phone, and just send the video from the mobile, just add the video from the mobile phone into the YouTube. Okay, so if you are not able to do this, and if you don't have enough time to do it, then you can go with the second method where you are showcasing all the things from your camera or your mobile phone. So that would be the second part which you can explore. And this was for the people who are using in the smart laptops. If you are using it in the mobile, so what you have to do is you have to do one thing, which would be I will just screencast again, and so once I am doing screencast, I will go to So what I will do is once I am doing the so I will just refresh it. So now as you can see, I am in the Play Store. So when you are doing it in the mobile phone, then also we will be using the external screen recorder. How we will be using it? We will be going to Play Store, and we will just search for screen recorder. And you would be able to find very good screen recorders in the Play Store, and you can install any of them. So all of them would be easy to use. So I will be just installing the second one, which is screen recorder and video recorder. I will just click on install. I will just install it. And after that, I will just show you how all these things work. So all the screen recorders work in a very similar manner. You just have to click on play, and a lot of you might be using it as well. So when you are doing it in the mobile phone, use an external screen recorder to record the screen of your or this like whatever it's like of the project. So I'll just click on open, and once I open it, it will show me, it's like it will do some things. So yeah, allow now as you can see, it's showing me how it works. So like you can just drag and drop and you would be able to see the things, see these menu, and I can just click on OK and allow, and now it would be like there is a button here coming here, and button coming here which you can see this one. This button is like a button which gives you an option to start recording or not. So what I will do is I will just click on this, and I will click on this button, allow record audio, allow, and I just have to give permission for first time. And when I click on start, it will show me 3, 2, 1, and I will be able to start this. So now it's recording. I can just go to PictoBlocks. I can go to PictoBlocks and it will like it will be showing me the recording as well. So I think there is some connection issue here. I will just refresh. Okay. I understood the part, because I am using the screencasting for showing you here, and then I am also recording it. If there might be a conflict. But I guess you got the idea in how you so you can see videos where you can see how you can use these things in order to record the videos. So yeah, so this is the part that we were covering for how to record videos for your projects. So this is very much important that you record a good video, explaining video, and submit it in Codeable. So yeah, so this is the part. Ayush, you can come back and just show them the next segment that we have, and we can close it out in another 15 minutes.
So I'm audible.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so students, I think you are clear with this part, that how you can make a video. Okay, so like there are two things. I'll just give you a short recap. So you can use like the link which has been shared by sir, that is OBS project. Okay, or you can directly use your phone and you can like work out with that and make a video explaining each and everything, explaining your part. Okay, after that, what you can do here is, students, otherwise, like if you are using an Android phones, right? So you can use a screen recorder, and that is, trust me, very simple. And I know maximum of you already know that how you can use the screen recorder. After that, you just saw, like I'll just show, give you, take you to the website first, okay?
Yeah, so the next part would be like uploading this to YouTube. So and that process is also very, very easy. So first thing that you have to do is you have to have a YouTube account. Yeah, Ayush, you can show them how you can. And we have also made a video on it. So which is a very descriptive video. So you can go over it if you want to, like if you want to see how to upload the video, then you can go over it and see it as well.
Okay. So now, students, I'll just show you like how you can make an how you can upload the video to the YouTube. So I think my screen is visible to you, right? So the only, like, you already have an email ID, right? So just the thing is, you have to go to the YouTube. Once you'll be going here to the YouTube, you have to log in here. You can see there is an option for login. Once you will be logged in here, there are two things, okay, which has to be taken care of.
Just one second. I think we are
Go ahead, now, students, you can see that there is a thing which is create a channel. Okay, But if in case you have already created your channel, then it would look like something like this. I'll show you. It will be coming there, that your channel. Okay. So I'll try to show you that part. Okay. Just give me a moment. So see, you can see for this account, I have no channel, but for other, it is saying no subscriber. So I'll just show you that part. So if in case, like you might have created the channel previously. Okay. So you don't have to worry that what's going on. I'm not able to see the things, how exactly it was told in the webinar. Only thing is now you will see, this is the part. Okay. Your channel. Okay. So I think you might have got the difference that if you have already a channel, you will be finding this option, your channel. If you don't, then you will be finding an option of create a channel. So I'll start with creation. So that those who don't have that channel, so they can also work with that. So just give me a moment. Yeah. Although the students who have their own channel, they can upload the videos to their own channel. Okay. The only things which is important is like while uploading, you have to use the tags. Okay. Which should be like Codeever 2020 AI and the different tags which are very important already, as Pankaj sir told you that we already have a video for this. You can go through with that as well, right? So here you can see, I'll click on create a channel. Okay. So it will say get started. I'll just click on get started. And here now you can see there are two options. First, you can custom the name of your channel. Okay. Or you can choose the current name. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select the current name, that is Ayush. Okay. So let's see. So although my internet connectivity, I think is like not good, but don't worry, it will take just a minute. Yeah. So now you can see it is saying upload your profile, right? So what you have to do, if you want to put any picture, it's okay. If don't, you don't want, there is no problem. The only thing is you have to give here your description. So anything you can write, as I mentioned, I'll just write the same again, the thing. Okay. So that, yeah, so I'll just copy that part. You can give a short description here. Okay. Not big description is required. A short description will work. If you want to add certain websites of yours, it's good. If not, you can like set up these things later. So now I'll just click on save and continue. So now you can see my channel has been created, right? So I'm getting an option to upload a video. So I'm just clicking here. You can see create, and I'll just click on upload video. Okay, so yeah, just give me a few minutes, students. Okay. Yeah. So you can like remove this. Now that you can see, it is asking for upload your video. So now till the time you have understood that how you can make the video. Okay. Now you also know that where you exactly have saved that video, right? Now what you can do is you can select file here and you have to upload that video which you have made. So what I'll do is I'll go to some like a video which I have already made. Okay, so this is the video. Okay, I'll just open it. And you will be able to see that it's opening. Now, the very important part is, students. So here you can see the title. Okay. So you have to give the title, students, the name of the project. Okay. So the time it will take for uploading, you can complete the, like the, I should say the details part. Okay. So here you will be giving, I should say the name of your project. Okay. So what I can do is I can write mask detector. Okay, and I'll write in PictoBlocks I can add. Okay, You can give a short description. After that, you will able to see some options. Okay, so don't worry with that. You have like, I'll just explain you a short part, but the most of the parts have already been covered in the the tutorial which we will be sharing to you. So now you can see even the my video is visible to you, right? So whether it's for kids or not, okay, so yes, I have made it for kids. If you're going to select yes, I have made it for kids, your comment section will not open. So what you can do is, I think you can not made for kids. I will go to more option. Now you have to see very important thing, that you have to add tags. So what tags you have to use? You can use some tags like codeable. Okay, just a moment. Okay, and okay, you can add some more tags of PictoBlocks. So you have to add the tags here so that this is going to help the different viewers to find the video. Okay, after once like the competition will over, definitely people will come and see your videos, right? And for that student, you have to put certain good tags here, which can be codeable, you can put PictoBlocks. Okay, and after that you have to click on next. Okay, so I'll just click on next here. Just let me check other details, right? So I'll just click on next here. Okay, now I'll just click here next. And now this is the part that you can put it as a private or you can put it as a public or unlisted. So everything is already described here. So if you are going to put it private, only you and the people you choose can watch your video, right? If you are putting it unlisted, anyone with the video link can watch your video. And if you are using a public, anyone who is going to find like searching for PictoBlocks will encounter your video. So this is upon you. Okay, you can say like select any part. So right now I'll just public it. Okay, and after that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on publish. Once I will be clicking on publish, okay.
Keep it either unlisted.
So
I think don't keep it at private.
So I think, students, this is very clear that you have to keep that as an unlisted, or you can use a public. Okay, don't put it private. Now this is the video link we are talking about, a student, that you have to copy this video link. Okay, and then I'll just close this part and I'll go back to my this video link section. Once I will be clicking it here and I will be like pasting the same link. Okay, and I'll click submit. So it will take a little bit of time to get submitted. We're going to show you that thing. And this part I'd like to tell you is totally same on the mobile, I think, right, sir? So now you can see that my project status is live, right? So now I have submitted my project. And it is with the codeable team, and they are going to like start working on that after once the submission date is completed. So you have to see this page at last once you are completed with the like submission. And this is something where you can like take rest, okay? And now you can like wait for the results. So I'm like stopping my share, okay? And we'll, yeah.
You can go to the share it again. One second, just I want to cover a few things there. People who have already submitted their projects, and if they want to edit their projects again, then they can do it. They can just go to click on edit and they would be able to do it. And other thing is, if you just click on mask detector, if you click on the project file, just click on mask detector.
Actually, right now we are on edit.
Okay, so
edit part. So here they can see, students, you can edit the things. Okay.
Yeah.
And I'll go back.
Again, yeah. And it's very important that your project is live. So there is a few mistakes that I will be telling you why your project is not being submitted. One would be your file, either your file is not being attached. That would be the one part. The other thing would be when you are putting up the link as like YouTube link or those things, then it has to start from a particular point, which is HTTPS. So that is something that you see on all websites, start with that part. So it's very important that you start with that part only. And if it's not being that done, then your project won't be submitted. If you are facing any problem with project submission, then fill the feedback form, send us the photo of what exactly problem, what exact problem that you are finding, and then we will be able to solve it as well. I will just click on mass detector. When you click on this title, then you would be able to see what you have submitted. So you would be able to see your project, your video, and all those things would be visible. So as you can see, Ayush project is visible here. The project description is visible, what theme he has selected, what category he is working on, and the explanation part, all those things are visible. And this is currently visible to you only. Okay, you only can see this part. And once the codable thing is over and we have decided and we have we have published the winners of the codable, we will make all the projects public as well. So all of you would be able to see each other's videos and get inspired with it as well. So we want that to happen as well. So that will be we will be doing at that point. So yeah. So this is how you would be able to submit the project. If you are facing any difficulty, then please fill up the feedback form or the doubt form. We will be getting back to you tomorrow. And there is one more thing, Ayush, you can share the link with all of them. Tomorrow we will be having, tomorrow and day after tomorrow, we will be having some Zoom sessions where you can interact with Ayush on interact with him. So like you would be able to say your problem and he will be taking care of the doubts as well. So if there is any specific problem that we haven't covered in this video, or if you are facing the problem again and again, then you can come back there and we would be solving the doubts. Okay, so this is so we will be sending out the mails as well. So we will be adding it into the mails as well. But if you want, you can just copy the message that Ayush has sent right now so that you are able to get to the link. And so it would be happening on 3rd of January from 11 to 1 p.m. tomorrow. And then there would be a second session from 5 to 7 p.m. tomorrow as well. Then there would be another session on 4th of January, which is Monday, which will be 11 to 1 p.m. Okay, so these are the three sessions that we are keeping for you in order to get interacted, like in order to interact with us and get your doubt solved. But before going there, if you have any doubt, then please submit the doubt form. Okay, it's very important that you submit the doubt form so that we are able to understand what doubts you are getting, and we will be taking care of the doubts. Like we will be contacting you as well. And we will be telling you what you can do in order to solve that doubt. So that would also be very much important. Ayush, you can add more things into it.
So like students, you can see we have already pasted the link for the doubt sessions on where we will be, like I will be taking one-on-one sessions. Okay, I'll try to like help you with the things. So you can join it. It is from like three sessions are there. First is tomorrow from like 11 to 1 morning time. After that, in evening also, we have one session from, I think, 5 to 7, right? And after that, again on 4th morning, 11 to 1. Also, students, whatever we have told you in this webinar, this will be uploaded to the YouTube. You will be getting the link for that. Also, I would like to share you all different links which will be helping you. Okay, so I want everyone to like copy these links and keep it with you. Okay, so that if you are finding any problem, till the time, right, like after this webinar, if you are finding a problem, where exactly you will come? Definitely you can send your doubts to the form, right? We will be replying you, but you can also refer to these videos, okay? So I'm sending you all the links one by one, and I want everyone to keep these, I should say, the links with you, or we will try to like even send these links on your email ID. So it will like be recorded for you, right? So yeah, so this was the...
Yeah, so what we will do is we will, yeah, so we will be putting this video on like STEMpedia main like YouTube channel. I would like you to go there and just subscribe to it so that you are able to get the update about the video. So I have posted the channel link as well. So go there, and we will be posting it out after 1 hour of this session. And then you can go over the video, go over each and every sections, and find out where, find out that point where you are facing difficulty and get your problem solved as well. If you have more problems, then Ayush will be doing sessions tomorrow and day after tomorrow, so you can come there and ask the doubts as well.
Right, so I think we have almost cleared everyone's doubt, like the basic doubts definitely, right? But your personal doubts will be taken care by me from tomorrow. But those students who are having no doubts, start working on the project and starts working towards the completion, okay? Because see, you have worked it so hard from so long, and definitely you should it's now time to showcase your talent to in an international portal, right? So now starts working towards the completion. So we have already pasted so many good links, so you can refer to these tutorials tomorrow. Join us on the doubt session for your personal doubts. Also students, you have been given a doubt form, right? So this is very important that you fill the doubt form, okay? You fill your problem, you can send the screenshots what you're facing, so that we can answer your questions as soon as possible, right? And your doubts get cleared and you complete your project, submit your project, and then wait for for the final results, okay? So I think, Pankaj sir, this was all from my side. Please add something.
Yeah, so all of you would be getting mails regarding the doubt sessions, and please check your mails and work on your projects. We are looking forward to getting a lot of exciting projects from you, and we want to enable you to make good projects and good videos and good projects. Some want you to submit good projects as well. So that's why we created this doubt session, so that you would be able to understand the basic doubts that you are getting. So login, sign in, or how to make project video, how to explain project, what to cover inside that. All those things we have covered here. Now the next thing would be, if you have any personal doubts, ask Ayush in the doubt sessions, and also go to our YouTube channel, and you can find out a lot of videos there about Codeover as well. So you can go over it, and then you can find out how to submit project, how to do a lot of things on Codeover as well. And you can also find some tutorials on our YouTube channel as well. So go there, explore, and you would be able to gain more out of it as well. So that's what we wanted to cover in this webinar, in this doubt session. But it's not the last doubt session that we will be doing. Ayush would be doing 3 more doubt sessions. Tomorrow there will be 2, and on day after tomorrow there will be 1. So if you have any doubts, come into the doubt session and get it solved. And so that's the part that we want to cover. And we will be having the chat open for just a few times, so that we are able to understand what our participants want, and maybe we can close it after that. So We know that a lot of you would be having problems, so it's very important that you submit the doubt form. So that would be a very important thing. Yeah, we are seeing people saying, yeah, so.
Okay, so I think.
Yeah, we are very welcome. We welcome you for the problem.
Okay, yeah. We can see like you like this session.
Yeah, and Happy New Year to all of you.
Yeah.
Is there any time limit on storytelling? You can make video of 1 to 10 minutes. We have kept the time as that 1 to 10 minutes of video you can do. And if you want to make the story out of picture blocks, you can do it definitely. Different software. You can search for other softwares as well. OBS or the software that I have used is just for the basic things. There are other softwares as well you can use. You can just search for screen recorder in Google and you will find tons of softwares. You can just use any of those. Yeah, it's Streamlabs OBS link. Yeah. Yeah, the session is now over. We are just taking the things. So can we use Discord? Like Discord would be very difficult for some of the students. So we know that there are students coming in from like who are 7 year age as well. So they won't be able to do it. So we are avoiding that. Yeah, we will be sending out the recording to you. So we will email to you as well. And you will also get the details about all the things, all the details about the class. So please check your email regularly so that you are able to get update of all the things.
So I would like to answer some questions I can see here. Is like first is, sir, is it compulsory to make a YouTube channel? So see, student, we have like kept this thing because so that you can even learn how exactly the things are going in the technology side, right? How exactly you will get in chance to interact with the YouTube as well, right? So if in case, just definitely we wish everyone for this, just think you are the first winner of this Codeover 2020 AI, right? So definitely there will be a chance for you to explore your expand your knowledge, okay, expand your your video to everyone, okay? Also, student, it will give us ease to let see your video, okay? Although we have told you, there are three things there, okay? There was like private, unlisted, and public. So if in case you are finding some problem with the YouTube, you can put it unlisted. There is no problem. Just use unlisted or public, okay? And you have to put the YouTube link there, you have to like upload the YouTube video and then paste the YouTube link only. Second thing I would like to answer, sir, when submission project, it should do not have an access. So I think you are finding a problem, something related to your password or username mismatch, okay? So what you can do is, so we have like shared you the links as well, but you can go to the Codeover website, just click on login, okay? After that, if you remember the password, it's good, or else you can click on the forget password, give your email ID and you will receive again a reset password link. And from there itself, you can reset your password, come back and log in. Your problem will be definitely resolved, okay? So, yeah, I think.
Yeah, it's okay if you like go beyond 10 minutes. It's preferred time, 1 to 10 minutes is preferred time, but don't go for like 60 minutes video.
Right. Okay, so I think maximum of the doubt.
So if you are getting if you are getting problems, then please fill up the doubt form. We are sending out the doubt form. If you're not filling up the doubt form, we won't be able to get in touch with you and we won't be able to solve the problem as well. So it's very important that you fill up the doubt form, and if you have any issues, fill it up. We will get back to you and we will do all the things. Okay, so I think we have the things going on. There would be another session tomorrow from 11 to 1, which Ayush will be taking. So you will be getting details on your email. And once you are getting the details, you will be able to join in, and we will he will be solving the doubts as well. Ayush, you can put down the link of the thing as well, so that people can just copy the link. Yeah, we will be checking all the doubts you have sent in the form, and we will for most of the things we will be contacting you, and you can also come into Zoom session where you can get your doubts solved there. So tomorrow 11, so Ayush has put down the dates. Just you can just copy it so that you are able to submit, able to join the meeting very, very easily. We will be also sending it out on the email, so you can also get the information of joining the Zoom session as well. So yeah, so that's it from for the this doubt session. This doubt session we will be uploading it on YouTube as well, so that a lot of you would be able to get familiar with the things. And we will also put down the Zoom meeting link on the YouTube description, so you can check out the link in the description as well. And thank you everyone for joining into this session. And I hope we have solved a lot of problems, and we are very happy to see a lot of people asking doubts, getting their doubts solved, and these are the things that we are working on as well. So thank you everyone for attending this session, and we will be closing the session now. Okay, bye
everyone. Thank you again, and Happy New Year.
Yeah, Happy New Year to everyone.